Hey guys, this video is dedicated to Apple users who either own a MacBook Pro, Mac Mini with an XDR display, studio display, or an iMac and are color grading in DaVinci Resolve. Since there are a lot of sloppy approaches to establish sound color management workflows in online forums, as well as here on YouTube, I would like to emphasize that this short tutorial is mainly intended for mastering Rec 709 2.4 right out of the box on your Apple devices running macOS. Normally, however, Rec 709 with a gamma of 2.2 would be preferable for most content creators and creators, as in most cases, the content is only delivered for web and social media channels. However, this can also be done later using a proper color space transform downstream your workflow. Now, back to the tutorial. The first step is to go to the system settings, click on displays. Make sure the MacBook Pro display or XDR display is selected. Then under reference modes, select the HDTV video BT709 BT8086 preset from the drop-down list. In addition, you can also change these settings very quickly via the control center. Just click on the control center, click on the display. There's a small arrow pointing to the right. And here you can see that we selected the HDTV video preset. Don't be surprised though that you can no longer change the screen brightness, as the reference mode limits the screen brightness to exactly 100 nits. Next, open DaVinci Resolve and click on DaVinci Resolve in the menu bar and select Preferences. Make sure System is selected at the top. Then click on General in the left-hand column. On the right side, check the boxes Use 10-bit precision in views if available. Also check Mac display color profiles for viewers. Now click on Save and restart DaVinci Resolve. Once DaVinci Resolve has restarted, open a project or create a new one. Then click on the gear icon in the bottom right corner to open up the project settings. Next, click on Color Management. At this point, you're given the option of letting DaVinci Resolve take over the color management or color manage yourself node base. The only crucial part is that you specify Rec 709 Gamma 2.4 as the output color space. Next, click on Save. And that's it. That's a basic framework for clean color management workflow on a Mac display without having to invest in a colorimeter and then having to calibrate your monitor, even though I would strongly encourage to do so in the long run. If you have asked yourself at some point during the tutorial why I have not mentioned or selected Rec 709A anywhere inside the settings, then let me tell you that although the Rec 709A gamma shift fix may temporarily display the correct image, for instance, after exporting in QuickTime on the Mac, the Rec 709A solution though ignores the fact that new problems will arise through incorrect tagging of the exported file. This will lead to new and far worse consequences, which even a trim pass at the end of the final color grade can no longer fix. We are talking about incorrect interpretation and application of wrong transfer functions due to incorrectly set meta tags. In the end, it's about knowing where and on which monitor the content is displayed by the viewer. If you want to learn more about these topics, comment down below. If you want me to upload a video about NCLC tags, deliver page in DaVinci Resolve, or CST in general, let me know too.